Hello, I'm Alexander Gogonia, Wireless Connectivity Product Marketing Engineer at STMicroelectronics. Today, I'm going to introduce you to BlueNRG Current Consumption Estimation Tool. The tool allows you to predict the current consumption for BlueNRG-MS, Bluetooth Low Energy Network Processor, and BlueNRG-1 and BlueNRG-2, which are the Bluetooth Low Energy systems on chip. First, let me give you a brief overview of BlueNRG series.
ST offers a Bluetooth Low Energy Network Processor called BlueNRG-MS that includes the 2.4 GHz radio, the Bluetooth Low Energy Protocol, and an application interface for the communication to the external microcontroller needed to host the profiles in the application. ST offers also application processors, BlueNRG-1 and BlueNRG-2, which are systems on chip, including both the radio and the M0 microcontroller. Therefore, an external microcontroller is not needed or it can be optional. Fully certified modules are available as well. If additional details are needed, please visit st.com/bluemodules.
Going back to the tool. This tool is a very effective way to get the average power consumption estimation of Bluetooth Low Energy and also a battery lifetime estimation. So, let's get started. I'll show you where you can get this tool.
This tool can be downloaded from st.com. Let's select BlueNRG-1, which is a Bluetooth Low Energy 4.2 system on chip with embedded Cortex M0 for running the user application code. The BlueNRG-1 includes 160 kilobytes of programmable flash memory and 24 kilobytes of static RAM peripherals and GPIOs. Here on the product webpage, under the section Tools and Software, you can see the BlueNRG Current Consumption Estimation Tool. Just hit the Get Software button and you'll be redirected to the myst.com login registration webpage. You'll have to complete the process and then you'll get the executable file that you'll have to install on your computer. This is a very straightforward process, so you should be up and running in a few minutes. So, now once the tool is installed on your computer, let's use it. As you can see, the tool is meant to be a graphical user interface where you can define the input parameters. Like, for example, you have a general section. So in the general section, by the way, for when you put your mouse on each parameters, you're going to get a description and you're going to get the details. So it's pretty easy. So as said, in the general section, you can define the type of device, high power mode, the power supply, the RAM detention, output power, the crystal startup time. So these are the parameters that can be defined. You can also define the event type like advertising, scanning, connection. So you're gonna get here on the right side of the graphical user interface, it's a performance summary. So for example, the time of the active phase, there is the plot. You get the power consumption during this active phase, so the average power consumption in the active phase, the total average power consumption related to the scenario that you have selected here. So for example, and you also get the payload data rate related to all the specification you have mentioned. Also, you get the battery lifetime estimation, which can be very handy. Of course, you're going to need to input the battery capacity. And also another nice thing about this tool is that you can save your data. So you can save the plot, the one that you see on the bottom. You can save a PDF report with all the details that I've shown you here in the interface. And also you can even save your settings, you can load the previous settings, and you can restore to the previous settings. So it's a very nice tool to get an idea of the average consumption estimation. Let's take a closer look to the current consumption numbers considering a specific use case. So let's set up here the BlueNRG-1 device and the supply voltage 3.3 volt, 24 kilobyte RAM, output power, crystal startup time, master sleep clock accuracy, and let's consider the advertising. Let's consider 28 byte and 1 second advertising interval on 3 channels. Here we get a performance summary. So here on the bottom is the active phase, the plot of the active phase. This is the timing, this is the average current consumption during the active phase, and this is the total average current consumption considering advertising with this interval and this advertising data length. Of course, you also get the payload data rate information. Using a 230 milliamp hour battery, You get also the battery lifetime estimation, so 1 year and 4 months. Now, for example, if we consider only one, like 100 millisecond interval, you're going to see that the total average current consumption goes up to about 180 microamp, and the battery lifetime is going to go down to a little bit over 1 month. This tool shows excellent correlation with real measurements. In order to verify that, you can refer to the application note 48020. So it's this one. You can find it on our website. You can take a look and you're going to see the power consumption numbers done using the eval boards and the one done using the power consumption estimation tool. There is a great correlation between them.
I hope you enjoyed this tutorial and you've noticed how easy it is to use this tool. Thank you for your interest and attention. If you'd like more information, please visit st.com.